63 of Ben's birthday special. We are playing Jeopardy for the Wii U. Let's see how I do in this game.
Johnny Gilbert, and thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. Let's take you right now into the Jeopardy round. Clues are worth $200 to $1,000 in these categories. Letters, trading places, Bible heroes, presidential alma maters, Star Trek jargon, and birth and death. Player one, at the burning bush, God told him he was the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Player one.
Who is Moses?
That's it. Player Goliath one. Mocked him, saying, am I a dog that thou comest to me with staves?
Who is David?
It's player one. You got it. Player one. Luke, he is quoted as saying, I indeed baptize you with water, but one mightier than I cometh. Player one? Right you are.
John the Baptist, yep.
Player one. When Jesus saw this tax collector and first gospel writer, he told him to follow me.
Who's Matthew?
Yes, player one? Yes. In Judges, he said, with the jaw of an ass have I slain 1,000 men. Okay, player one.
Who is Samson?
Yes. Player one. The number one cause of death in the United States isn't cancer, but disease of this organ.
What's the heart?
Okay, player one. The cuneiform tablet, dating to 2000 BC, is the first known reference to the type of birth associated with this Roman leader. Let's hear it, player one. Good. The death in Death in Venice is from this waterborne disease that has caused several pandemics. Let's hear it, player one. Right. So Louise Brown, the first baby conceived as the result of in vitro fertilization, was born in this decade. It's player one. Any other takers? Yes, player three. Anyone else want to hazard a guess on this? It's player two. All right, let's get back into this. Player two has control. For 2011, the 10 highest fertility rates were in countries on this continent. Yes, player one? Good for you. a 2.0 GPA.
What's C?
Okay, player one. That's correct. It stands for a metric unit equal to about a quarter gallon.
What is L?
Let's hear it, player one. That is correct. It's the 21st letter of our alphabet.
What is U?
Let's hear it, player one. That's correct. Yeah. Player one. Morse code, it's three dots.
What is S?
Okay, player one. Yes. Layer if one. Your trademark application is okay, you can follow the trademarked item with this letter in a circle.
What is R?
It's player one. That is correct. Layer one. U.S. Military Academy, class of 1915. It's player one. Anyone else want to hazard a guess on this? Okay, player two. That's not right. Anyone else? It's player three. You got it. Player three, make a selection, please, as we continue. The type two of this weapon had a max power setting of 16 and could be set to heat, disrupt, or stun. Okay, player one. That's correct. Layer this one. Device briefly converts a person to energy, beams the energy, then reassembles the person. Okay, player one. That's it. Player one. When Spock checks chronometric data, he's looking at measurements of the space this continuum. Yes, player one. Created by Starfleet, it prohibits interference with other civilizations. Let's hear it, player one. Sorry, that's wrong. Any other takers? Here's what we wanted. The Prime Directive. Player this one. Crystal regulates matter-antimatter reactions that provide energy for travel faster than light. Let's hear it, player one. Sorry. Any other takers? Player three? Any other takers? Player two. Player two, where do we start? U.S. Naval Academy, class of 1946. Okay, player one. Nope. Any other takers? Let's hear it, player two. Nope. Anyone else? Player three? Correct. Player three, make a selection, please, as we continue. Georgetown, class of 1968. Let's hear it, player one. Harvard University, class of 1904. Let's hear it, player one. No, that's not right. Any other takers? We're talking about Franklin Roosevelt.
Layer one.
Eureka College, class of 1932.
Layer one.
Any other takers? We're talking about Ronald Reagan.
Layer one.
Let's get Jimmy's assistance on this clue.
Near two major rivers, this Missouri city was founded as a fur trading post by Pierre Leclerc in 1763.
Layer one.
That's right. Way to go. Layer Frankfurt's
one.
Rossmarkt was a site for this type of animal trading, also a term for hard bargaining.
Okay, layer one.
That is correct.
Layer
located
one.
On this continent, the Kanem-Bornu Empire lasted 1,000 years by being a center of trade.
Yes, player one.
Oh.
Any other takers? Let's hear it, player two.
Player two, make a selection, please, as we continue. This city's grand bazaar was built in 1461 by Sultan Mehmed the Conqueror.
Layer one.
Yeah.
Here's the $1,000 clue for you. It's the Daily Double.
Yeah.
You are in the lead right now. What are you going to wait for? Here is your clue. From its founding in 1898 until 1919, this exchange was known as the Chicago Butter and Egg Board. You have dropped down to the second. The correct response is Chicago Mercantile Exchange.
Mm-hmm.
Player three is in third place and will select first in the Double Jeopardy round, as we always do, right after this break. Let's see what happens in Double Jeopardy with these categories awaiting the players. Colleges and universities. Astronomy. College football coaching legends. Questions from a 1927 quiz book. Biblical warriors. And French class. Okay, let's get back into this, player three. You make the next selection. As with the demotion of Pluto, it's now the smallest, least massive planet. Let's hear it, player one. That is correct. Oh, to northern observers, the most brilliant part of the Milky Way is found in the Archer, this constellation. Yes, player one? Nope.
Ugh.
Anyone else care to try to come up with a correct response? Yes, player two. Sorry. Anyone else care to try to come up with a correct response? Okay, player three. That is correct. Player three, where do we start? The trustees of the College of California bought 160 acres of land north of Oakland and named the site this in 1866. Yes, player one? Yes. Where this Tulsa College was founded by and named for an evangelist, later the school's chancellor. Player one? Yes. Founded as a Methodist college in 1838, it moved to Durham, North Carolina in 1892. Yes, player one? You got it.
start us off.
The modern sport of bungee jumping got off the ground in 1979 when this school's dangerous sports club jumped off a bridge in Bristol, England.
Let's hear it, player one. No. Anyone else? We're talking about Oxford. You again?
Yeah!
One of the daily doubles. And you're in the lead now. All right, here's your clue. The athletic teams of this Massachusetts college are nicknamed the Lord Jeffs. Here's the response we were looking for. Amherst College. Player one, from the Latin for kernel, this solid center of a comet consists of ice and dust particles. It's player one. That's correct. Player one. This critique of Pure Reason author called some fuzzy objects island universes in 1775. He was right. Yes, player one. Anyone else care to try to come up with the correct response? Player two.
Oh.
Nope. Anyone else want to hazard a guess on this? It's player three. Yes, great, you're back into it now. All right, let's get back into this. Player 3 has control. The constellation Coma Berenices, or Berenice's hair, was given its exact form by this Dane in the 1500s. Player 1? That's it. Good. Back on the plus side. Where do we begin? Joshua's conquest of Canaan began with the taking of Jericho, a city in this river's valley. Yes, player one. Right. Saul and this son, who shares his name with a famous seagull, both died at the Battle of Mount Gilboa. Player one. That is correct. Later lending his name to a popular hotel Bible, he led a successful night attack against the Midianites. It's player one. Correct. Joab was this Israelite king's successful commander when he conquered Jerusalem around 1000 BC. Player one? Yes. Player this one. Female judge won an important battle against the Canaanites by luring them into marshland. Let's hear it, player one.
Yeah!
You get to pick again. Woody Hayes, 1951 to 1978. Let's hear it, player one. No, sorry. Any other takers? Here's the response we were looking for. Ohio State. Player Bo Schembechler, 1969 to 1989. Player one? No. Anyone else? We're talking about Michigan. Player Tom one. Osborne, 1973-1997. It's player one.
Bobby Bowden, 1976 to 2009. Player one. Good. Vince Dooley, 1964 to 1988. Yes, player one. Sorry, that's wrong. Any other takers? Player two. No. Anyone else care to try to come up with a correct response? Let's hear it, player three. Player three, you start. Fin de siècle refers specifically to the ending of one of these time periods. Yes, player one? Where in French, the English Channel is called La Manche, meaning this part of a shirt or coat. Okay, player one. No, sorry. Any other takers? Here's what we wanted. The sleeve.
Oh.
Answer. The other day, they double. You are good. All right, here's your clue. Literally half world. It's a class of women of dubious reputation. You have maintained your lead. Player, literally, a la mode doesn't mean with ice cream, but this two-word phrase. Okay, player one. It's the branch of cooking devoted to prepared meat products such as ham and pate. Okay, player one. Select again. Article 10 of this international organization's covenant implies that an attack on one is an attack on all. Let's hear it, player one. Sorry, that's wrong. Anyone else? Here's the correct response. League of Nations. You get Alfred E. Smith and William Gibbs McAdoo. Were two of the candidates for this party's presidential nomination in 1924. Okay, player one. Correct. This cabinet department is in charge of the enforcement of prohibition. Let's hear it, player one. No, that's not right. Anyone else? Here's the correct response. Treasury. Player one, the Tacna-Arica boundary line dispute involves Chile and this neighbor to the north. Let's hear it, player one. Now, the $2,000 clue. The present presiding officer of the U.S. Senate is this vice president. Player one. Sorry, that's wrong. Any other takers? Player two. Only two of you will be going on to Final Jeopardy. Sorry, player two. Here comes the final Jeopardy player. The category is this. Ancient names. What are you going to wait for? And the last clue? Appropriately, the name of this dramatist comes from Greek words meaning wise and famous. What did you say? And this correct response will have how much to your score?
Well, at least I got Ben $7,000, which is not a terrible.
Let's see
money.
Your response. And that will cost you.
Oh, well. But I still win nonetheless.
Congratulations, player one. You're the winner.
I'll see you all for that next segment. That final segment, actually.
So long.